I'm Sal Robertson.
I'm Levi Kitchen.
I'm Zach Osborne.
I'm Ryder DeFrancisco.
I'm Jalek.
My name's Shane McElrath.
It's RJ Hampshire.
I'm Dean Wilson.
I'm Vince Friese, and I choose OGO.
I choose OGO.
I choose OGO.
I choose OGO.
Pretty brutal. And just honestly frustrated with myself, really. I feel like heat race, I got a good start. Went into the hay bales, like blew that. And then main event, blew the start. And it came from last to seventh or eighth, I don't know where I was at, but not where I need to be, honestly. Like, I feel like, yeah, we have some stuff to work on with the bike, but I feel like I can overpower the struggles I have and like get to where I need to be. And it's just coming a little bit harder this year. So it is what it is. We'll get back to work on this little break and come out angry and swinging in Atlanta, right? That's the next one.
Yeah, next
one. So yeah, we'll do that. So it is what it is. The weekend, I would say very, very mediocre. I do feel like I at least rode decent when I got around, everybody that got around. So it is what it is. It's racing. We'll get back to it.
Honestly, qualifying was the best I've had. Felt super comfortable on the bike. Felt really snappy. And after that, kind of forgot how to ride. Heat race was not good. Made too many mistakes. I just kind of, you know, rode around. And then the main event, got off to a normal shit start. And made my way through the pack. And yeah, I don't know, just wasn't gelling with the track in the main and was just kind of making it hard on myself.
Overall, it was okay. First heat race win. That was awesome. Super exciting to do it here with the team's hometown race. Main event, I just kind of got bumped on the start, and I went from what was going to be like a top three start to maybe like eighth or ninth, and that was a bummer. And I kind of I tried to empty the tank and see what I could do, if I could catch up to that lead three or four guys, and I just didn't have it to push. I don't know, there's a little bit of energy maybe I used in the heat, and whatever it was, I was just kind of popped and didn't have the juice to get up there in the mix. But that was a bummer. I felt like I could have been on the podium tonight with a start there. But overall, heat win. Got to be happy with that. Solid night, and hometown race is up next.
Okay, how was the heat win? Because that was big, and that was fun to see. So how was it from your perspective?
It was good. I mean, I got the start, and I was like, you know, the whoops were gnarly. So I was kind of just holding on. I think there was like three laps to go. I looked at the countdown and I saw Mike Genova leaning out of the manager's tower, and I was like, all right, I can't give this one up. Like, Nate was put on some pretty good pressure, right? So saw that, thought, okay, hometown race for the team. I can't give this one up. And I kind of had to dig deep. I mean, Nate's good, man. He hits those whoops good. He was putting the pressure on. That Yamaha's loud too, and it was in my ear, and I was feeling it for sure. But I was glad to hang on to that one. There's been a bunch, not just this year, but in years past, of heat races that I've led for a long ways and blown it, whether it's a lap to go or two laps to go. And I didn't want to blow that one for sure, and I'm glad I was able to hang on to it.
Bittersweet. It was tough. Lost my rear brake about halfway through, but man, I am so proud of my first few laps. It felt good. So I'm gonna really just kind of remember that part of it. And but yeah, track broke down. I was trying to learn how to make do with no rear brake, and it was tricky. So to be able to adapt to the track, to be able to cut down, you know, it's helpful to have some rear brake to charge into stuff. So it slowed me down quite a bit, but I'm proud of holding on to third, you know, still take home a podium on a tough night. So not happy when I really think I could have won that night. I mean, especially with a little bit of a lead at the beginning, and a lot of the mistakes after our past Christian were just as a rear brake, so tricky.
You know, you had a kind of chaotic one. Did the brake going out, was that because you hit Christian, you think?
Yeah.
And then you and Joe got into it there too. In the last lap, he came over. You and Christian didn't really say anything. Just kind of things happen. Like, is that just kind of what went on?
Yeah, of course. It's entertainment, you know, and we're here. We all want to improve our spots, whether that's for a podium or for the win. And so I'm going for a championship, and I don't intend to ride dirty. And I don't think it was particularly dirty, but it was definitely an aggressive move. And I mean, he knew I was coming in. He absolutely knew, and he decided to hold it in there. And, you know, I think it's largely because I've ridden him really respectfully. And, you know, it's tricky because I have one side of fans and friends and, you know, team who are saying, oh, man, you're being too weak. You need to make it happen when the time is there. And then I have a whole other side of people that are telling me, oh, you're over-aggressive, you're dirty, you're this, that. It's like, can't please everyone. So I'm just going to try to do my best, go for wins, and, you know, let the cards fall where they may, let the noise be where it is and what it is. And I can't stop it. I can't make it how I want. Can't please everyone.
Oh, tough. Got off to a sick start, and I've struggled with my starts all day, and then when it counted, I got off to a good one, and then rode tight in the beginning, a little frustrating. Michael got a tad aggressive. He could have passed me. I knew he was a little faster in the beginning, so he had to block pass, and he had to do a little extra and take me out. So, man, once again, come from behind. So I think I got up around 5th or 6th, put my head down, and then caught up to these guys. And by that time, man, Hunter was in his zone, and it was hard to try to like match his speed. But it stings just because of how it went. But I got to look big picture and keep doing what I'm doing, and it'll pay off the day.
Hey, that was a big stare down when you came off. Like, clearly you were pretty frustrated. Did you guys say anything?
No, I mean, I'm not going to sit here and whine. It's just, it stung a little bit, just the way it was handled. So usually we like to ride clean, and that's, like I said, three times now I've gotten cleaned out for the win. So I got to put myself in a better position, I guess, and so I let these things happen. So it is what it is. Aggressive racing happens. I'm not going to sit here and whine and complain. It's just, it stung, and I'm going to take a couple minutes to get mad, but we'll get over it and move on.
Okay, hey, last thing. We've got three races left, 2 showdowns and 1 normal. How do you feel going into this? I mean, obviously you've got point lead, but this is a way different scenario than you've ever had.
Yeah, for sure. Obviously, I got to look big picture, and that's the title. So, you know, I really want to go out there and challenge Jet. Obviously, he's the best on that coast right now. So, but I also got to be smart and keep doing what I'm doing. And if the win's in my picture, then I'll take it. But, you know, if it's not, we'll just try to be there, be in the front, and control my own destiny.
I bet that felt good after so many weeks of just sitting there waiting for the next skate drop off.
Fuck yeah. Especially how A3 ended. I really feel like that was the night where I could have pounced in the later of the motor, but obviously I crashed, so this one felt good. It was a tough one. It was really tough. The track was actually insane. The whoops were just like, I don't know if you've seen Rad, the movie, but it was like hell track out there. So, no, Rad, stoked. Can't thank my team enough. Today was tough. We were really grafting during the day, and I had to really rely on them on a lot of decisions where I was scratching my head. So, yeah, this was special. It was for everyone, this one. This was a team effort, 100%.
Okay, hey, obviously you probably saw something happen between Christian and Michael, and then you kind of start charging your way forward. What did you think? What happened? And then how did the race go from there?
Yeah, so I was really kind of didn't find my stride on the first few laps, so I was trying to push, get into that cadence where I could, you know, hopefully catch them and then battle. But yeah, obviously Michael cleaned out Christian, which I was like, okay, no worries, just one less guy. And yeah, we ended up passing Michael, and then it was kind of tough because there were so many lappers. I wasn't really sure on like where they were behind me, but mate, just stayed focused, looked forward, and pulled it off. So stoked for the win.